In PowerPoint, you can create the illusion of motion from static image sequences without applying any built-in animation effects. This technique is often referred to as frame-by-frame animation or stop-motion animation in PowerPoint. Here is how it works. Insert or paste the static sequences image into the slide, and now select the image. Move to the Picture Format tab, and then click the Crop command. Adjust the crop size to match with the first sequence of the image. You can also align the image to the center and middle of the slide from the Align drop-down button. From the Thumbnail pane, right-click on the slide and choose Duplicate Slide. On the second slide, select the image, go to Picture Format, and then again, click the Crop command. Now adjust the second frame of the image in the exact same location. Repeat the same steps by duplicating the second slide, and then adjusting the third static frame of the image to the same location. You can also take the help of guides from the View menu. You can add more horizontal and vertical guides to exactly define the position of the image frames to be placed on. Now repeat all the steps described earlier to duplicate the slide, crop, and then place a separate frame of the static image on each of the slide. And there we have 8 slides, each having a different pose of the static image. From the thumbnail pane, select the first slide, and then press Ctrl A key to select all the slides, or select the first slide, hold down the Shift key, and then select the last slide. Move to the Transitions tab, and we don't actually need to apply any transition and make sure it is set to none. In the duration box, set a very short time for each of the selected slide, like 0.10 seconds. Also, make sure to uncheck the on mouse click option and then make a check mark on after but without any further delay timings and set that to 0 seconds. That way, each slide will be displayed just for 0.10 seconds. And all the 8 slides will get played in total 0.80 seconds during slideshow, creating a nice frame-by-frame animation. Now let us take a look at another example, where we have a total of 20 different poses of a character in a single static image. We will repeat the same steps of cropping the image, placing the frame to the desired location, duplicating the slide, and then adjusting the next frame on the next slide. We will repeat those steps 20 times to have each different pose of the character on each of the slide totaling 20 slides. Once we have all the frames, select all the slides from the thumbnail pane, go to the Transitions tab, and adjust the duration as required. See the slideshow and there you have a frame-by-frame animation from the static images, so you can turn any static images into a nice animation.